Hey guys, Jersey Drew 98 here, and I'm here to do a review of the new film, The King of Staten Island. The film is directed by Judd Apatow, who you might know from TV shows and films he's worked on before, such as Freaks and Geeks, Knocked Up, Trainwreck with Amy Schumer, which I believe was only 5 years ago, actually. The film has been released on various VOD streaming platforms due to this whole coronavirus quarantine thing we're all dealing with right now, but I still think it's pretty cool that studios are finding ways to release new films using the streaming platforms we already have. Obviously, you're probably not going to see something like Tenet, Wonder Woman 2, or Quiet Place 2 getting released through streaming, as they're hoping to bring in more money through the box office. But it's cool that smaller films like this are still getting out to the public. So the basic plot of this film is we follow the lead character, played by Pete Davidson, named Scott, who has had a case of arrested development ever since his firefighter dad passed away. He spends most of his day smoking weed and dreaming of being a tattoo artist until events force him to grapple with his grief and take steps forward into his life. So like I said before, this is Pete Davidson leading this movie. This is really his first soiree into leading an actual movie. He's had bigger roles in films like Hulu's Big Time Adolescence, which is also really good. But this is his first time really taking the helms and starring, being the top of the call sheet. And for the most part, I thought he did a really good job. This is more of a more dramatic role for him. The humor is definitely still there, and the humor really shines for him. I think he's a funny guy, and it really comes off in this one. He's kind of playing a version of himself, but that's not always the easiest thing to do, and I thought he did that very well. And I mean, you can have your own opinions on Pete Davidson off camera and off the big screen, but here, I think he really solidifies himself as an actor, not just a comedian trying to be an actor or whatever you might think of him. He really nails this role. So although we do see Pete touch a dramatic side in this role, Pete and the film remain very funny. I mean, it's a Judd Apatow movie, so if you're a fan of his humor, which I am, you're really going to be familiar with the type of humor in this film. It's never funny to the point where the characters don't feel real. I still feel like every character is very grounded, and the humor when it works is hilarious. That being said, I felt that the blend of humor and drama was done very well, and the movie really felt grounded, and a lot of the characters felt relatable. I myself found myself relating to the lead character, Scott, played by Pete Davidson, quite a bit. Throughout the film, he kind of starts off as like a snarky, funny, kind of almost dick character, and it almost seems like, okay, there goes Pete Davidson maybe doing a shtick. But the film does a really good job of peeling back those layers and really letting you get to know the character of Scott and kind of know why he is the way he is. There's a lot of honest moments in this movie where I can't help but feel that this must have been quite cathartic for Pete, which a lot of these events in the movie are kind of loosely based on his actual life. Pete's father being a firefighter who died in 9/11, and some of the mental health and personal health issues that Scott and Pete deal with are kind of in this movie. So you kind of get to know and understand Pete Davidson as a person through the character of Scott, almost in the way that you did in 2019, Honey Boy with Shia LaBeouf. Two very different films, but I think you gain respect, or at least the understanding of each actor, Shia LaBeouf and Pete Davidson respectively, based on these cathartic type therapy session stories that they're telling. In this film, you really get to know Scott's character and these moments of honesty where he's talking about, you know, losing his father at age 7, having like these manic episodes of like impulsive behavior and being scared of himself and his decisions, his struggles with ADD, and basically his struggles to really move forward in life, which I found some of those elements really compelling and really relatable. And I thought he did a really good job balancing both sides of the character. And there are some scenes where he's acting off of Bill Burr's kids in the film. And that really gets to show you what kind of person Scott is. That, yeah, he has this coping mechanism of humor and sarcasm and sometimes being a little bit of a douche. But deep down, he really does care about people and he has a really sweet heart. and you really get to see his passion and just the true person that's kind of hidden behind the mask that he puts on. Also starring in the film is Marissa Tomei, who I'm a big fan of, and she was really great in this movie, and you really believe her as playing Scott's mom, as playing this mom where she really, really loves her son, and she understands what he's going through, what he's gone through, how that's affected him, but she kind of struggles with helping him move on with his life, and she does a really good job and plays it really well of kind of like that struggle that you have as a parent, which I mean, I don't know, but only from what I know from my parents, that struggle you have as a parent, you just want the best for your kid, and sometimes you just got to be a little bit more rough, a little bit more tough with your love to help them, to push them forward, and I thought she did that very well. Bill Burr also in the movie, very funny. You get it, that typical Bill Burr humor, hot-headedness, but he's more three-dimensional than that. He has more to his character. He kind of plays off a little bit more subdued, a little bit more, he has a sweet heart. Yeah, he also does have the hot-headedness, but I really believed him as kind of like this stepdad-ish figure that comes in and is just trying to, really loves Marissa Tomei, the mom, Scott's mom, and is really just trying to make it work with her and also her son that still lives at home. And the dynamic between him and Pete Davidson butting heads is really entertaining and funny, but also heartfelt throughout certain areas of the film. I thought they worked really well together, and I thought that their little storyline was pretty great. So Maude Apatow, Judd Apatow's oldest daughter, is in the film. She plays Pete Davidson's younger sister, and I thought she was really great. I thought she was a standout in the film. I thought she played the role that she was given very well. She plays the younger sister, kind of has her stuff together, graduated high school, is going to college, and even though she plays the younger sister, the film and her did a very good job of portraying this different dynamic where she kind of feels like the older sibling, looking after Scott and worrying about Scott. And then also giving the different perspective of resenting him a little bit for some of the all that attention that he demanded as a kid, and now that kind of pulled attention away from her. But at the end of the day, she really just loves her brother and wants to see his life move forward. And I thought she did a really great job. And basically, that's what the movie's about. It's about Scott finding his way and finding a way to move on and move out of the rut and arrested development that he's in. And that part of his journey really kicks off as soon as he finds a way to raise Firehouse. I won't say how, because this is going to be a non-spoiler review. But as soon as he finds his way there, that kind of kickstarts his journey. Ray and Steve Buscemi's character, Papa, who's referring to the film, he's the chief of the fire department, head of the fire department. I don't know the exact term. But those firefighters really take in Scott and take them in as one of their own. And many of them knew of Scott's father, Stan. And through them, Scott kind of has this cathartic experience that he's been needing, where he learns more about his father and not just the stories that his mom's told him. And he realizes that him and his father are more alike than he thought. And his dad isn't this picture-perfect saint that his mom tried to paint him to be because, you know, she's just trying to do the best she could. And through the stories of his father and through those firefighters and his time working at the firehouse, that's when he really goes and begins and sets off on his journey. Overall, I really enjoyed the film. There are just only a couple things that didn't work for me. One of them being sometimes the humor fell flat. And this is a problem with like almost any comedy. This is a comedy film in itself is subjective, and humor and sense of humor is even more subjective. So to me, sometimes the humor felt flat, and it kind of felt like it was trying too hard to be edgy, and just like maybe if they would have pulled back a couple of the jokes to just tighten it up a little bit. That was one of my main issues. The other issue being the pacing. I kind of felt like the first half of the film could have been wrapped up a little bit quicker. I feel like the point they were trying to make with Scott's character was made for me halfway through the first half, and I didn't really need the rest of it. And going into the second half, where I think the film really hits its stride, I think it feels a little rushed. And I feel that given the 2 hour and 17 minute runtime, I felt there was plenty of time to sort out that pacing, and I wish they would have evenly paced it a little bit more. But overall, I gotta say, I really enjoyed the film. I felt the film had a really good blend of humor, drama, great performances. It looks great, shot on 35, and it had a heart to it and a relatability to it and a groundedness to it that I feel is really going to benefit on rewatch, and I think this movie does have a really good opportunity to get better during rewatch, and I think that maybe my expectations of the pacing might resolve itself watching it again. But as of right now, I'm going to go ahead and give it a 7.5 out of 10. I think it's a really solid movie. I think you guys should check it out. If you want to go ahead and check it out, like I said, it's available on iTunes, Prime Video, Fandango Now, basically anywhere that you can rent movies, you can see this movie, and I'd say it's really worth the watch. Anyways, guys, that's been my review of The King of Staten Island. If you guys enjoyed the review, go ahead and like and subscribe if you'd be so kind. Also, let me know what you guys thought about the movie. Did you like it? Did you not? Are you interested in seeing it? Go ahead and let me know down in the comments below. I'd love to get a conversation with you guys and maybe change my opinion or hear what you guys got to say. So go ahead and leave the comments below, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.